Hi everybody, thanks for tuning in. This video is about Betalink, a software that we developed in our lab to connect Betafly to Simulink. What is Betafly? Betafly is a very popular open source flight controller for FPV drones. It is actively developed by more than 100 contributors and runs on various types of MCUs, like the system on chips from STM, F1, F3, F4, F7. It currently supports more than 300 flight controllers. It is highly configurable thanks to a GUI called Betafly Configurator. It provides adaptive filtering, which is the feature that is used to make Betalink work. Adaptive filtering, that means that it uses notch filters that cancels the vibration effect of imbalance propellers on the IMU. This notch filter uses feedback from the motors, velocity feedback from the motor drivers called ESC, and this feedback is digital, and in Betalink we use this feedback to regulate accurately the velocity, the spinning velocity of the propellers, in order to compensate for drops in battery voltage or discrepancies between the motors and other disturbances. So what is Betalink more precisely? Betalink comes in the form of a patch, but not a patch that you can apply automatically. It is a patch that is described with a text. The text of the patch is available here in notes.txt. And it is a text file, obviously, that lists all the modifications you have to make in to the source of Betafly in order to add the specific features of Betalink. Of course, this is not an automatic procedure, but it is more robust to changes in the versions and the releases of Betafly. So what does it add? It adds low-level PID, in fact only PI, regulation of motor velocity using telemetry coming from the ESCs. So ESCs, it is an acronym that means electronic speed controllers. In fact, it is only the power electronics that drives the synchronous motors used for drones. There is no speed regulation, in fact. It is equivalent when you control the throttle of your motor, so you send the throttle value to your ESC. In fact, it is equivalent to controlling the voltage of an equivalent DC motor. So synchronous motors are brushless DC motor, but in fact these motors are alternate current three-phase motors, but the equivalent model of this motor is the model of a DC motor, and when you change the throttle, in fact what you do is changing the voltage of the equivalent DC motor. So everybody knows, should know, that changing the voltage of a DC motor does not regulate its velocity. If you have a varying load, of course the velocity will change accordingly to the variations of the load, and there is no feedback. A quick interruption to make some additional explanations about the equivalent model of a DC motor. In fact, a DC motor has some feedback within the motor. This feedback is due to the counter electromotive force, which is a voltage that opposes to the armature voltage that you send to your motor. So there is some kind of feedback, but it is not a feedback that you design. You do not design a specific control law for the motor. It is the motor that intrinsically has a feedback. But it depends on the windings, on the kVs, and on the parameters of the motor, and mainly on this K value, the gain between the velocity of the rotor and the voltage of the counter electromotive force. And a DC brushless motor is a synchronous motor, three-phase synchronous motors, with a driver, so the ESC, and this combination behaves like a standard DC motor. It is called DC brushless motor because it is the same as a DC motor, but only without brushes due to the collector assembly. So to do this, you have to make a loop, a feedback loop, and Betalink uses feedback from a telemetry signal that is digital. So this PID loop use velocity feedback coming from the ESC given by a protocol called D-SHOT. In fact, it is a special version of this protocol called bidirectional D-SHOT that allows you to send from the flight controller to the ESC the current throttle value and to retrieve in the other direction from the ESC to the flight controller the current velocity. And this protocol is digital and it is a very high speed. So you have a very low latency due to the transmission. And Betalink uses this feedback to accurately control the velocity of the motors thanks to a PI regulation with anti-wind-up feature. This regulation compensates for differences between the motors due, for example, to differences between the friction, the mechanical friction of the motor, or differences due to different kVs of the motors, and can also compensate for drops, variations of the battery voltage. So this is the main feature of Betalink, a core feature that runs directly into the flight controller at a very high refresh rate. In fact, it is the same refresh rate than the PID that is used to stabilize the drone. In current flight controllers with modern hardware, you can achieve 8 kHz for the sampling rate of this regulation. So, in order to communicate to and from the outside with Betalink, we added a new opcode, operation code, to the list of already available MSP opcode. MSP is a protocol, is a serial link protocol used by Betaflight to communicate bidirectionally with the outside. And we added simply one more opcode that is called Betalink that sends the velocity reference from the outside to the flight controller, and that in the same transaction that retrieves the telemetry, some telemetry values like the current velocity of the motors, the RPMs of all the motors, the acceleration, the gyro data of the IMU, the magnetometer data if available, the estimation of the attitude, roll, pitch, yaw, that is given by an embedded estimator that runs directly into Betaflight. And also some power supply data, like the battery voltage, the battery amperage, and the battery the current consumption. So the third feature that is added by Betalink is a watchdog. So our modifications are very minimal. We will see it in the next part of the video. I will go step by step through all the process of building a new Betalink firmware based on Betaflight, and we will flash it on a board, on a specific board, and we will test it. And since the modifications are minimal, it is still compatible with Betaflight configurator. You can use a GUI, the Betaflight GUI, to configure your flight controller, some parameters of your flight controller, which is very handy. And you could even use your flight controller to fly FPV. There is no incompatibility. It is only, we add only one more feature, little feature, but it is transparent with respect to the normal use of the flight controller. In this video, in fact, I will tell you how to build a new firmware, a Betalink firmware. And in the next video, I will explain you how to interface Betalink directly using Simulink. So we developed in our lab a toolbox, an open source free toolbox called RPIT. RPIT means Raspberry Pi Target. And this toolbox provides one block, many blocks in fact, but one block is to connect with Betalink. And you can see this block has input the throttle. So the throttle, in fact, it is not the throttle, it is the reference value, the reference for the low level velocity loop. But within a certain range, if you send control signals, throttle between 1000 and 2000, it is interpreted by Betalink as a real throttle. So you may also use this block to send directly the throttle and to bypass the regulation. But if you send a throttle value that is greater than, I think, 3000, it is interpreted by Betalink as a velocity reference, and the PI loop, the PI velocity loop, will be switched on. And in this second video, I will show you how to use this block, and you can use multiple blocks within one Simulink simulation. In fact, it is not a simulation; it is a hardware in the loop experiment, where the block stands for an interface between Simulink and a real hardware. And you can see that you can this block allows you to retrieve many data from the flight controller, like the timestamp in microsecond of the flight controller, RPM of all the motors, some information about the telemetry link quality, percentage of transmission error, should be zero, accelerometer, gyrometer, magnetometer data coming from the IMU that is in the flight controller, roll pitch yaw, this attitude given by the local estimator, and battery voltage, battery amperage, and battery milliamp hour. And you can use this in real time to make a high level regulation. This block, since the transaction between Simulink and Betalink is very fast, depending on the MCU that you use, on a F4 STM32, it is slower than on F7. On F7, you can achieve up to, I think, 300 Hz, and on F4, you can achieve only 100 Hz. But it is sufficient in, for a higher level regulation to control your drone directly within Simulink using Betaflight compatible flight controller, and and lots of boards are available into this ecosystem. So this is the outline of a series of three videos that will be published in the coming weeks on my YouTube channel. The first video, this one, will focus on a step-by-step walkthrough explaining how to build the Betalink firmware. Also how to modify the source of Betaflight before building it. And then in the second part, we will flash and test the Betalink firmware using a simple command line program also provided by Betalink. We will test the firmware on a drone and on two different flight controllers. In a third video, we will test Betalink within Simulink. We will test the Betalink block of Simulink and explaining how it works, what are the features, what are the limitations also. You will get all the information that you need to confidently use Betalink within Simulink. So let us start from scratch. So I'm here on a Mac, macOS, but you can do the same on a Linux system. So first of all, you open a terminal. Here I created a temp directory. And first of all, you have to download, to clone the current Betalink repository, GitHub repository. So you go to GitHub. So you search for Betalink. This is my GitHub, and this is the project name. And you clone this with this command. So you type git clone this link, and it should download all the project. Now you open your project. I use a bbedit, and it will show you all the files in the project. And you open notes. This gives you a complete walkthrough, step-by-step walkthrough to install, to build your Betalink firmware. So first step, install Betaflight source code. So into the Betalink folder, download Betaflight current release source code by entering this line. Okay. So some explanation here. This command here tells Git to download the 4.2.11 version of Betaflight. It is the latest stable release. It might change in a near future, since Betaflight 4.3 is currently in pre-release stage. And Devs 1 tells Git to only to skip all the history of change of all the files. So this saves a lot of space. In fact, you do not need all the history. Okay. Now you have two sub folders, subdirectories in your temp directory, and you go to the next step. You have to within the Betaflight directory, so you go into the Betaflight directory and you type this command, make ARM SDK install. And this will download all the binaries needed for your platform to cross-compile code, the firmware for the ARM STM32 platform. Take some time. Okay. Perfect. We go to the next step. The next step is the more involving step, but not too complicated. Just follow the instruction. You have to modify the Betaflight firmware. So first of all, you open Betaflight within your preferred editor. So open Betaflight. Okay. So new window here. And first step, you open the file called msp.c in main msp at the line 147. So you go to source, src, main, msp, msp.c, line 147, near this line, in fact, here, and you add these three lines. Simply cut, sorry, cut, paste. Okay. So additional external declaration here. It is the right position here at the header of the file. First step. Second step, in the same file, you go to nearly the end of the file. And you add, just after the switch, you add all this code. This adds the new opcode to the list of opcodes. In fact, the code that handles the new opcode into a switch case. And you go to nearly the end, 1918. Here, just after the switch, here, oops, paste, okay, you added a new opcode here that is called msp underscore betalink and the code that handles this opcode. Save. Next step. I will do this one first. In fact, in the folder MSP, you open mstprotocol.h, and you copy paste at the end this new opcode, mspprotocol.h. Go to the end of file and paste this new opcode, 207. It is an unused value, of course, and here you have all the other opcodes that are used by Betaflight. Okay, save. Then do this. In the main flight, rpmfilter.c, remove static at line 67. In flight, rpmfilter, flight 67. Okay, here you have to remove static. Why? Simply because you need to make this variable global. This is the only reason. Then add the watchdog code. So copy paste this watchdog code. Go to mspserial.c. mspserial.c here, and you have to go to near line 500, and just before this line here. So 500 here, just before this line equal null here, you put your watchdog code. Okay, down. After that, in the same file, you have to add some includes near line 37 here. After that, you add this three includes. Okay, and finally, in the same file, you have to declare near line 49 two external variables. Two external variables, 49, okay, here. And it's done for this file, and you have to open now mspserial.h and add a define. This is the number of serial task polling periods to trigger the watchdog. If your watchdog is too slow, you find it is too slow, you can decrease this value, but be aware that if you put a too small value here for the watchdog, and if you refresh too slowly your reference, of course, your watchdog will trigger at every sampling rate, and your motors will not spin. Okay, watchdog, line 31, mspserial.h. 31 here, you add a new define. Okay, and last step, but not least, you have to add the regulation of the motor speed. Since this regulation is pretty more complicated, I have put it in a separate file, and all you have to do is to include this this file. So it is more easy to do. And to do so, you have to open core.c. So core.c near line 1272, you have to add this include, and it includes directly C code here. And it is pointing to this file. Of course, you have to respect the layout of the folders, as I show you. Since if you do not respect this, this will not point to this file. And you will get an error. So in core.c main flight controller. Core.c, yeah. Okay, it is here. And just before task main PID loop, just before function task main PID loop, as stated here, you have to include this code. So this is only the declaration of the regulation function. And of course, you have to call it here in the main PID task. Of the flight controller, and to call it, you only have to copy paste this line and put it after subtask rc command after that. So you locate this subtask rc command and you put your call to the regulators, save. Okay, it should be finished for the modification. So you see it is a very slight modification and easy to do. And it is robust. I think it is pretty robust to changes to to f future changes in the code of Betaflight. Of course, if Betaflight changes a lot, this nodes, this instruction might be a little bit off with respect to the current state of the code, and of course we will update this instruction accordingly to the evolution of Betaflight in the future. Now you can compile. So to do the compilation, you go to the Betaflight folder within your terminal. You already be there. And you enter such a command, but here you have to modify this target name. Here it is as STM32F745. It is a target for obviously F7. It is a directive, an instruction to compile a target for F7 MCU. But you have to adapt this to your current board. So here I have two boards. Will show you the flashing on two boards. This board is from FlyWoo. It is a F7 MCU. So we'll make some tests at the end on this board. But I have another board here with a motor connected. That is from iFlight. iFlight is the manufacturer of this board. The two boards are all-in-one boards. That means that you have on one side the flight controller, the MCU running the flight controller, so Betaflight modified Betalink, and on the other side you can see you have some power device, power transistor here, MOSFETs, and also some other STM32 MCUs. In fact, you have four such MCUs, one for each motor. So on the same board you have the flight controller and the ESC, and the connection are made of obviously directly on the PCB. This is very handy and it works very well, and it is very compact, and of course you save a lot of weight by using such boards, all-in-one boards. And this one is also an all-in-one board, but a little bit older, from iFlight. And also you have here, you can see here the power layer with some capacitors here. Here you have the MOSFETs for the three phases of the motors. So you can see here the connections to the motor, three phases. So synchronous motor with outrunning rotor and static windings. And here obviously the connector to the lipo battery. And here on every Betaflight board you can plug a USB cable that you plug to your computer, and it is through this connection that we will communicate to Betaflight. This is the main way of communicating, the easiest way, the most convenient. But you can also directly allocate. There are some outputs on the board here using, for example, this connector that can be used to directly send MSP commands, so Betalink commands, through a direct serial link. It is also possible, and it works. It might be even more responsive by using directly a serial link, because if you use the USB, It will be serial link emulated by USB. So you will have some additional de delay due to this emulation. Okay, and this on the other side of this iFlight all-in-one board, you have the flight controller with the STM32 here, the main, and it is a F4 on this one. Okay, so the first firmware that I want to compile is for this frame. So I have to change here the name of the target. So I will show you later how you can get the right name of the target thanks to Betaflight Configurator. I will tell you where to pick up this info. For now, I will just here copy and paste this target name that is within parentheses here. We'll tell you later where you can get this information. So make target for F405 MCU. Enter. So the compilation should be quick, very fast. And you should have no errors and no warnings. If you have a warning, it should be you should look into it. I think I have digged very deeply in the, of course, in the Betaflight code in order to make Betalink, and it is very well written. So we end up here with the firmware that is in the obj directory. So you go to obj, into obj, and here you have your firmware. So this concludes the first part of this series of three videos, and the next video will be dedicated to the flashing procedure and testing of the Betalink firmware with a simple command line program. Thanks for watching.